here we are going to discuss a topic called as a paradox of fractional oxidation number. Okay, sometimes we will get the oxidation number in fractions, that is called as a paradox of fractional oxidation state. So let us take the oxidation state of carbon in C3O2. C3O2 is called as carbon suboxide. Okay, what is called as carbon suboxide? So in this one, basically, if you find out in the normal method, C3 into C plus 2 into oxygen is equal to 0. So 3 into carbon plus 2 into oxygen oxidation number will be minus 2. Therefore, it is going to be 0. So 3 into carbon is equal to plus 4. So plus 4 by 3. But oxidation number is fractional. Now, it is, we are going to give you the paradox of it. In the paradox, what we will do, we will try to derive the structure. Okay, this is the structure of the carbon suboxide. This is the structure of what? Carbon suboxide. So here, if we substitute the oxidation number, actually it depends upon the electronegativity. Here carbon is less electronegative than the oxygen. So here these two are there. So this will be less electronegative, therefore plus 2, and it is more electronegative, minus 2. Here carbon is with another carbon, carbon is with another carbon. So any element with the same other element, oxidation number will be 0. So here again it will be plus 2 because of this one, minus 2. Okay. So the oxidation number of this carbon is plus 2. Oxidation number of this carbon is 0. Oxidation number of this carbon is plus 2. So why we are getting plus 4 by 3? Paradox is plus 2 plus 0 plus 2 divided by total 3 carbons. Therefore, we are getting plus 4. Okay? Plus 4 by 3. Understood? Why is it plus 4 by 3 normal method and structure method, I think, clear? So try to utilize the same process and find out the paradox of fractional oxidation state of bromine in BR4O6. Okay, normal method, if you find out, you may get the different oxidation state, and with the structure method, if you find, it will be different. Okay. See here, normal method, I am talking about the BR4. 4 into bromine plus 6 into oxygen, and what must be the answer? Answer must be 0, it is a molecule. 4 into bromine plus 6 into oxygen, it will be minus 2. So you will be getting 0. 4 bromine is equal to plus 12. Bromine is equal to how much? Plus 3. Okay. So, but according to paradox and structure. Now, how to draw the structure? Very simple. Try to write the 4 bromine. How many bromine? 4 bromine. Okay. And 6 oxygens are there. Sorry. My question itself was wrong. Very sorry. It was 8. Okay. BrO4H. Okay. So you can change over here 8. You can change over here 8. Okay. So then it will be plus 16. So plus 16 by 4. My question was wrong. So Br will be plus 16 by 4. Plus 16 by 4. How much you will be getting normal method? Plus 4. Okay. Br4. Oh, sorry. wait. Br3O8. Something is wrong today. Br3O8. Br3O8 was the question. So 3 into bromine. Okay. So plus 16 by 3. What will be the answer? Plus 16 by 3. So how to write the structure? First, what I will do, I will be writing the total 3 bromine. How many bromine? 3 bromine. And as a together there will be at least one bond. Total 8 oxygens are there. 1, 2, 3. And each oxygen will minimum to minimum it will form 2 bonds. Okay. So out of the 8 oxygen, I have utilized only 6. Therefore, 2 oxygens I will write it here. Now I think you can find out the oxidation number of each and every bromine with respect to its number of bonds. Electronegativity I am writing here. Electronegativity of bromine is less than electronegativity of oxygen. Electronegativity of bromine. As per this method, I am getting fractional oxidation state, +16/3. Okay. Now, if you try this, then you will get the correct answer. 3 bromine is equal to +16. Bromine will be equal to +16/3. Okay. Now, here, see, because of these bonds, I am writing for each and everyone. So, because of this bond, it will be +2, -2. Because of this bond, +2, -2. Because of this bond, +2 and -2. So, bromine-bromine bond, you need not to count. So, total bromine, which is at the extreme left, you will get oxidation number of how much? +6. Okay. And let us count about this bromine. Because of this bond, it will be -2, +2. Because of this bond, it will be -2, +2. So here, what is the oxidation number of bromine? Central bromine will be +4. Okay. So same way, -2, +2, -2, +2, -2, +2. So this bromine also will have an oxidation number of how much? +6. Okay. So if you add all of them, +6, +4, +6. And total 3 bromine are there. It will be how much? 16/3. So this is what called as a paradox of fractional oxidation state. Okay. Make a note of it. So the previous example, the paradox was explained. Paradox of fractional oxidation state was explained because of the molecular structure. Okay. Now the another paradox of fractional oxidation state is explained on the basis of mixed oxide. Okay. This process is paradox with respect to the mixed oxide. Okay. Mixed oxide. So I will give you it is a Pb3O4 is a mixed oxide of 1 mole of PbO2 and 2 moles of PbO. When you combine both of them, you will get 1 mole of Pb3O4. Okay. So if you find the oxidation number of this one, you will get +4. If you find the oxidation number of this one, you will be getting +2. So, but if you find out directly what will be the fractional oxidation state, it will be +8/3. Okay. Now, how to get +8/3 here? So how we will get to +4? Okay, +2 into +2, and total lead are 3. So when you get to divide and add, then you will get +8/3. This is the paradox of fractional oxidation state in case of the mixed oxide. In case of what? Mixed oxide. Now let's check with the Fe3O4. Fe3O4 composition is different. 1 mole of Fe2O3 and 1 mole of FeO. Okay, whatever the way I have written, you will write fourth example also. Whatever the way I have written Mn3O4, you will write that also. Okay, MnO plus 2 moles of MnO and 1 mole of MnO2. 1 mole of MnO2. Okay. Okay, here Fe2O3 and FeO. So if I find over here, you will get +3. And if you find here, you will get +2. Okay. So, but how it is, if I find directly here, you will get +8/3. But how you are getting +8/3? It is because 2 into +3 plus 1 into plus 2, 2 into plus 3 plus 1 into plus 2. And total iron are how many? 3. Okay, so this is going to be plus 8 by 3. So our intention is to show the paradox when you directly find out, and with the mixed oxide you find out, both answer must be same. Okay, so same way here, if I find out plus 2, here if I find out plus 4, so 2 into plus 2 plus 1 into plus 4, and total number of manganese are 3, so plus 8 by 3. Okay, so then this also will be plus 8 by 3, and our answer also plus 8 by 3. Just make a note of it. So there is another paradox will be based on the structure we have done, based on the fractional oxidation, based upon the mixed oxide we have done, and third one is the addition compound. Okay, so if you do it in the normal way, okay, so potassium plus 3 into iodine, okay, 3 into iodine, oxidation number will be how much? 0. So potassium plus 3 into iodine, oxidation number can be minus 1. Or if you put potassium, you will get the oxidation number. Like alkali metals are supposed to show the oxidation number how much? Oxidation number of alkali metals will be plus 1. Okay, plus 3 into iodine. Because iodine can show oxidation state from the minus 1 to plus 7. But alkali metal show oxidation state only plus 1. Okay, in ionic state or compound state, and elemental state it is 0. So here it is going to be 0. That means iodine oxidation number, how much I am getting? Minus 1 by 3. Okay, so this is a fractional oxidation state. Now its paradox is, actually Ki3 is an addition compound of potassium iodide plus iodine. Okay, potassium iodide plus iodine. So here what happens, this is in element state, this will be 0. This is in compound state, once it is plus 1 and minus 1. Okay, so that means all the 3 iodine have the different oxidation state. One iodine got minus 1, another iodine got 0, another iodine got 0. So why I am getting minus 1 by 3? Because it is first one will be minus 1, minus 1 plus 0 plus 0 divided by 3, it is equal to minus 1 by 3. So this is what our paradox of fractional oxidation state in the addition compounds. Okay, now we are into the next topic called as a stop notation. Okay. Stop notation will be used for specially those element which shows variable oxidation state. Okay, variable oxidation state. So what do you mean by stop notation, and what is variable oxidation state, that I am going to tell you. Okay, suppose if I write iron chloride. Okay, if I write what chloride? Iron chloride. But the problem is that iron can exhibit oxidation number of plus 3 also. Iron can exhibit plus 2 also. Earlier, what they used to show, it is a plus 3 oxidation state, then they used to write ferric. Okay. If the oxidation state is plus 2, okay, the oxidation state is plus 2. If the oxidation state is plus 2, then they used to write ferrous. Okay, this was the old convention method. Okay, so if I write the name according to the old conventional method. Okay, so let us take FeCl3, and if we take FeCl2, so then it will become as a ferric chloride. Then it will become what? Ferric chloride. And if it is FeCl2, then it will be ferrous chloride. Okay, ferrous chloride. Now, but in the stock notation, what they are doing, iron, in bracket its oxidation state is 3, iron 3 chloride, okay. Now, here it is clearly mentioned, same way iron 2 chloride, this is what called as a stock notation, okay, stock notation. Note down this. And I will give you the one question related to it, like tin, okay, SN. SN can show plus 2 and plus 4. SN can show plus 2 and plus 4. You have to write the name of SNCl2 and SNBr2, SNCl4, okay. SNCl2 as well as SNCl4, both names, according to the stock notation, according to the old notation, okay. So, like earlier it used to, they used to call it as a stannous, less is there, therefore it will be stannous chloride, okay. And this will be called as stannic, okay, stannic chloride. Is it understood? Stannic chloride. Now, as per the stock notation, what it is going to be? Tin. Yes, very good. Tin 2 chloride. Very nice. Okay. And then it will be tin 4. Tin 4 chloride. Tin 4 chloride. Okay. Make a note of it. Okay. Next is cuprous sulfate. Write its formula as well as stock notation. Okay. Here, cuprous, actually copper can exhibit oxidation state of plus 1 as well as plus 2. So here us means plus 1 oxidation state, okay. So Cu plus 1 and SO4 minus 2. So this 2 will come here, this 1 will come here, okay. So Cu2 SO4. Understood? Otherwise, you can write bracket also, not required. Okay, if not required, no problem. Now, stock notation formula. It will be copper. Okay, copper bracket oxidation number 1. And it will be sulfate. In the bracket, you will use the Roman numbers. Okay, next, let us check with the fourth one. AuRIC, auric nitrate. Okay, try write formula and stock notation. Okay, here auric nitrate. Auric means gold. Okay, and gold symbol will be what? Au. And gold can show two oxidation state, plus 1 as well as plus 3. Gold can show plus 1 and plus 3. So here equiward shows that highest oxidation state, okay. So Au will be plus 3, nitrate will be minus 1. So minus 1 will be here, plus 3 will be here. So formula will be AuNO3 whole thrice, auric nitrate. Formula will be AuNO3 and stock notation name will be gold, oxidation number 3 and nitrate, gold nitrate. Is it understood? Now we will do the next part. Take a note of it or take a screenshot, then write down. Argentis, items. I will give you the name. Silver, silver 1 phosphate. Okay. So if stock notation is there, you should be able to write the formula. Silver 1 phosphate. Okay, here silver 1 phosphate. Silver means Ag and its oxidation number given as PO, plus 1. And BO4 oxidation number will be minus 3. So minus 3 you will write here, 1 you will write here. So it is going to be Ag3PO4. And what will be the name? Argentus. Okay. Because iron can show plus 2 and plus 1. Argentus phosphate. Argentus what? Phosphate. Is it clear? I think today's topics we have completed about the stock notation, paradox of fractional oxidation state. Okay.